In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to place a logo or a design in perspective non-destructively so that you can always come back and make any changes that you want. Hey everybody, welcome back to the Photoshop Training Channel. My name is Jesus Ramirez and you can find me on Instagram at JR from PTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to place any design or logo into any surface in perspective, and we're going to do it all non-destructively. That way, you can always come back and edit the contents of that design or logo. This is a technique that I came up with when I was working as a designer, and it's really helpful in a production environment where you have to work non-destructively and you have to work fast. Also, make sure that you stick around until the end of the tutorial so that you can see how I use adjustment layers to make this composite more realistic. And even though we're working with a billboard in this tutorial, you can apply the principles that you're going to learn to any other surface, like the side of a wall, the side of a truck, or anything else, really. Okay, let's get started. We're going to work with this file that contains our background image, that contains this blank billboard, and this is where we're going to place our design. We also have this layer here, titled Company Logo, and it's just a generic company logo with some text. And if we wanted to place this company logo onto this design, what you might have seen in the past is people telling you to press Ctrl T, Command T to transform, and then right click and select Distort and try to match the perspective. And you can probably eyeball it and get a decent result, but that's not what we're going to do here. So I'm going to press the Escape key. And the biggest problem is that we don't know the aspect ratio of this billboard. Even if we have something with a similar shape, we can't match the corners of the billboard to match our design because it will be distorted. It's a different aspect ratio. So if I press Ctrl T, Command T to transform and select distort and try to match it, we might get the perspective right, but this won't necessarily be the right aspect ratio. We're stretching the image. And sure, we can right click and select scale, hold shift and alt, shift option in the Mac and scale it down to try to center it, but that doesn't solve our problem. I know that some of you may be thinking that we could use a new blank layer, then select the company logo and make a copy of it by going to edit and copy, and then in the blank layer using the vanishing point. And the vanishing point simply allows you to make a grid where you can paste something in perspective. And that sort of solves our problem. We have this grid here, and I can press Ctrl V, Command V to place that logo, and I can move it in perspective, and that works. But the problem is that this is not a smart object. We cannot apply that filter using a smart object. So I want to be able to have a smart object that I can just place anything I want in there and have it match the perspective of the billboard. So I'm going to disable this. And what I recommend you do is use this little trick that, again, as I said before, this is something that I came up with when I was working as a designer and I was doing a lot of these types of jobs. I'm not sure if anybody else is using this technique, but I certainly haven't seen anyone use it on a YouTube video. So I decided to create this tutorial for you. And basically, you select the perspective crop tool. And I've already set up guides on this image to make things a little easier for me. So I'm going to press Ctrl H, Command H on the Mac. So I have these guides that I created off screen, but they're simple to create. You just need to click and drag on the rulers. If you don't have the rulers, you can go into View, Rulers. And that's how you enable and disable them. And all I really did is created rulers that match the corners of my billboard. And I have Snap selected under View. So I can quickly just click on that corner and it'll snap to the next corner and click. And that way I always make sure that I'm clicking on the right corner. And what the perspective crop tool does is it takes something into perspective like so, and then you commit the changes and it crops it and removes the perspective. So now we have a flat view of that billboard. So now we know exactly what the aspect ratio of that billboard is. So I'm simply going to press Ctrl A, Command A on the Mac to select all. So I'm selecting everything in the canvas. Then I can either use the keyboard shortcut or go into Edit, Copy Merge. Then I'm going to undo. So I'm going to press Ctrl Alt Z, Command Option Z on the Mac to undo. And I'm going to undo several steps until we go back into the original image. Then I can go into Edit, Paste, or I could press Control V, Command V on the Mac to paste. So now this layer here is going to be our placeholder. So I'm going to rename it placeholder. Then I'm going to convert it into a smart object. So I'm going to right click and select convert to smart object. Then I'm going to press Control T, Command T to transform. Then right click and select distort. And I'm just going to click and drag the corners to those same spots. And I'm going to commit the changes by either hitting enter or clicking on the check mark. And I'm going to press Control H, Command H on the Mac to hide all extras, including the guides. And you'll see now that we essentially have the original image once again. But now I can double click on the placeholder. And this is my template for anything I want to put in that billboard. So I can go back into my original design and select this company logo. I'm going to click on the move tool, click and drag that logo onto the next tab by hovering over the tab and holding shift and releasing, and that'll place the logo in the center. And I really don't need this placeholder for now, so I can just disable it, and I can press Control S, Command S on the Mac to save. And now that logo is there in perspective, and let me disable the original. Now, the advantage of using this workflow is that I can double click on this placeholder smart object, and I can add any image that I want, and it will always be in perspective. So let me select an image from my libraries panel, and I'm just going to select this image of Hong Kong, and I'm just going to drag it into place, and I'm going to scale it so that it fits the entire canvas. And it's okay that I'm covering the logo. I really don't need it. And I'm also going to select the type tool and just type Photoshop Training Channel. And then click on the check mark to commit the changes. And here's a trick for you. If you press Control A, Command and the Mac to select all, then click on the move tool, you can click on the center verticals and center horizontal buttons. And now the text is right in the center. But I really don't want it in the center vertically. I want it a little lower, so right about here. Then I can press Control S, Command S to save. And if I go back into my perspective view, there it is. And you might notice that we have a few problems. Number one, we haven't properly masked the building. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. And I'm going to disable this placeholder layer. And one of the easiest ways of doing it is by selecting the polygonal lasso tool and just zoom in and make a selection around this area of the building. And you only have to be precise on the top here. The rest really is not that important in terms of being precise. Then you can hold Alt Option on the Mac and click on the layer mask icon to create an inverted layer mask. Then when I zoom out, you'll see that we have that part. Then I'm going to change the blending mode of this layer to multiply. In this case, this particular background doesn't really have a shadow, but if it did, I would want that shadow to come through, and the multiply blending mode would do that for me. Also, it'll make it easier for me to mask out these lights. So I'm going to click on the zoom tool, zoom in into one of these lights, and in the placeholder layer mask, I'm going to paint with black in areas where I want to reveal these lights. And I'm using the bracket keys on the keyboard to reduce the size of my brush. And for something like this, maybe you want to use a harder brush, something that is not so soft. We have hard edges, so those soft edges don't do that good of a job in this type of masking. So that's the first light. What I'm going to do now is pause the video and continue with the other lights so you don't waste time watching me do the same thing three times. Okay, I've gone ahead and masked out all the lights from the billboard, so this is my result. And again, you really didn't miss much. I just essentially did the same thing that you saw me do with all the other lights. Now, the final step is to make the billboard look a little more realistic. After all, this is a compositing job. So if you look at the billboard, there's a couple of things that don't look realistic. Number one, it doesn't look like it fits on this scene. And the reason is that the original image from the city doesn't match the atmosphere, the luminance of our scene. So one of the things that you can do is create a black and white adjustment layer just so that you can remove the color of the image and just look at the luminance values. And that helps your brain really see what's going on. So I'm going to click on the placeholder and then create a Levels Adjustment Layer. Click on this icon to clip it to the layer below. Then I can use this middle slider to adjust the contrast. And I think it's got too much contrast. And I think that the darks are too dark. So I'm going to click and drag this slider to the right a little bit. And at least to my eye, that looks much better. And this is what it looks like with color. So that's before and after. Also, I think that this layer has a lot of saturation. So I'm going to create a new hue and saturation adjustment layer, clip it to the layer below, and I'm just going to drag the saturation down on the entire image like so. And now this looks a little bit more like a print on a billboard. So that's before and after. And the advantage of using this workflow is that you can always come back and make adjustments to the contents of this billboard without having to redo anything else. So I'm going to double click on the placeholder, and maybe we're working on a campaign that has different cities. So we have Hong Kong there, and we can also drag in maybe Sydney. So now we have an image of Sydney here. So I'm going to just make that larger so that it fits within the canvas. And I'm going to drag it below the word Photoshop Training Channel, but this time I'm going to click and drag the words Photoshop Training Channel to the top, right there. Press Control S, Command S to save. Go back into my working document, and there it is. Everything is in perspective. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Let me know in the comments if you enjoy this perspective crop technique. Also, if this is your first time in the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. And I will talk to you again soon.